everyone, it's RubidiumMoon here, bringing you guys another video. Today, we're playing Respect Part 2. So let's get back into it. Here we go. Let's run it. This sucks. Why is Monica such a jerk? She should be grateful that I even joined her stupid club. It's not like she can find any members. Monica's usually really nice. She cares so much about everyone in the club being happy. Yeah, right. Well, she usually does. Maybe when she's not busy being so judgmental. So what if I'm into manga? Why can't just one person accept that? Instead of being so condescending about it. I accept it. I think it's cute. Oh, come on. That's condescending too. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it like that. I just want to support you. Natsuki sighs. I know. Thanks. It just really sucks. Do you want me to talk to Monica? I don't know. It's not like it's gonna change her opinion of me. Like, even if you were to convince her to back off, that wouldn't suddenly make me feel like I'm actually welcome in the club. I should just find another club. Wait, you don't have to do that. We can figure this out. Please? I mean, I'm the vice president, or at least I think I am. And I don't want to leave. I don't want you to leave. Everyone deserves to feel welcome and to be happy. So, I want to make that happen for you. I was wondering, what was the reason you decided to join the literature club? Well, Natsuki hesitates. It's kind of dumb. Ah, don't say that. There's no such thing as a dumb reason when everyone is welcome. I wasn't welcome. You were to me. So? Just don't tell anyone, okay? Especially Monica. I promise. Natsuki sighs. I'm just tired of everyone judging me all the time. I can't enjoy any of the stuff I'm into without people making snotty comments about it. Not that I care about what anyone else thinks. But, you know, the signs for the literature club said that you can be yourself or whatever. So I decided it was at least worth a shot. But that was a lie, apparently. Natsuki dejectedly kicks the toe of her shoe against the wall. Oh, and I like writing too. Really? How come you didn't say that to Monica? Because she was being so judgmental that I didn't just want to tell her something she wanted to hear. She didn't deserve that kind of satisfaction. And if she knew I was into writing, then she would just be like everyone else and try to push me away from the manga in favor of the more mature thing. The two of them remained silent for a while. Sayori understands that it's out of the question for Natsuki to return to the club room for today, at least. But Natsuki has a reason. Has a reason for wanting to join the club, just like everyone else. It's part of the club vision for her to be welcome. You deserve to express yourself as much as everyone else does. That's supposed to be what the club is for. So, I'm going to do everything I can to fix this. I promise. It's lunchtime the next day. Cafeteria and hallways are bustling with students rushing to meet with their friends make the most out of their limited break time. Where could she be? Among them is Monica, who always eats lunch in her classroom. But she has some additional business today. Fearing Natsuki would avoid coming to the club, Monica decided to try to find her during lunch, so that she could make amends. After searching for an extensive time, Monica finally spots her. Despite her short stature, Natsuki's bright hair helps her stand out from the crowd. Oh gosh. Suddenly feeling awkward, Monica is afraid to get closer. Natsuki is with some friends whom Monica doesn't recognize, and they're all energetically chatting together. It would be really tactless to just interrupt them. Oh, yeah. Did you end up joining that literature club or what? Huh? Of course I joined. Why wouldn't I? Ha! I told you she would join. Come on. You know she only joined because you wouldn't stop giving her crap about the anime club. I told you. I never wanted to join that stupid club. Oh, sure. Well, you have to give her some credit for at least making an effort to finally grow past that trash. True. Well, congrats on finally graduating middle school, Natsuki. We're proud of you. Shut up. Just let me do my thing. I'm just joking. You know we love you. Yeah, once the literature club makes you a famous writer, we'll be the first ones to buy your book. What? You're gonna buy her smutty fan fiction? Well, obviously, I wanted a signed copy. That was like years ago. You don't think I've grown out of it by now? I told you I was joking. Besides, it's a good reminder of how far you've come since then. Not to mention, you couldn't have done it without us. That gives us a pass to joke about it. Yeah, sure. They grow up so fast. It brings a tear to my eye. Natsuki suddenly glances in Monica's direction, prompting Monica to quickly turn away and distance herself. What the heck? That was horrible. I should have said something to defend her. Why did I have to be so conflict avoidant? Not that I deserve to say anything. I'm hardly better than them. After the way I treated her. I'm so awful. I'm not doing anything right. After school ends, Monica distractedly makes her way to the club room. She finds Yuri already inside, eyes on a book as usual. Monica picks a desk and slumps into it, something she seems to be doing rather often lately. Yuri, I don't think I can be club president. I suck at handling anything that doesn't go like exactly my way. Yuri looks up from her book. It's like the literature club is a place where you get to express yourself. Unless it's in a way I don't like. I'm so mad at myself. I'm especially mad that I didn't have the self-reflection skills to realize what I was doing. So much for maturity. Sorry. I really shouldn't be complaining complaining out loud like this. There's just like a lot on my mind. No. Hmm? I enjoy listening. Really? Mm-hmm. Why? Yuri shrugs. It just makes me feel nice. Oh. Well, okay. I'll just continue then. Yuri nods. Yeah. I just... Well... Natsuki has a... kind of a blunt attitude, you know. It made me feel like she wasn't taking the club seriously. I couldn't even figure out why she wanted to join. I saw her friends talking to her in the hallway during lunch. They were just so mean to her. Telling her to grow up and stuff that the Literature Club would help her grow out of her manga. It just made me so mad, like, just let her enjoy it. It makes her happy. Why are you trying to take that away from her? And when I had that thought, it was when I came to the realization that I was kind of doing the same thing, just in a roundabout way. I should have made her feel good about being passionate about something, but I just dismissed it. No. I was actually trying to avoid acknowledging it at all. I even did that with you, Yuri. When you first joined the club? You did? Yeah, I remember. Fantasy isn't really my thing. So I was kind of trying to dismiss it, but then Yuri jumped in and took over the conversation. I should have reflected on that, but I didn't. Because I just let Sayori handle it instead. Now, I'm repeating the same mistake, except I really hurt someone this time. Monica shakes her head. I'm so tired of being afraid of things I'm not comfortable with. It's so stupid. Like, I could just picture how much joy it would bring Natsuki if I let her share her passion a little. I'm so angry that her friends were treating her like that. I'm going to get them back for it. Get them back? Yeah. I'll get them back. By making sure that this is the Literature Club that Natsuki wants. Not the one that they want. Suddenly, Sayori bursts through the door, making Monica and Yuri jump. With a rare, stern face, she marches over to Monica's desk and sits down next to her. I'm having an intervention. I can do that because I'm vice president. Is this about Natsuki? Yes. Yeah, I know. I messed up. I'm super sorry. I was just talking to Yuri about it. Really? I was so dismissive of her passion that she felt threatened and probably just unwelcome. Literally the opposite of what the Literature Club is supposed to be. I really need to make it up to her. Oh! Yay! I did it! Thanks for the intervention, Sayori. I'm glad we're on the same page. Friendship wins again. So, how do you want to make it up to her? I have a plan. Sayori, do you know if Natsuki is coming to the club meeting today? I don't think she is. I see. Monica was afraid of that. Not because of her plan, but because she's facing the consequences of the damage she's inadvertently caused. But the only way to do the right thing is to face it head on. It's so easy to just duck away from conflict and wait for it to blow over. But that's not enough. To truly respect someone's feelings after you've hurt them is to face them and admit your wrongdoing. Not the wrongdoing of mismanaging the club, but the wrongdoing of disrespecting Natsuki's feelings. Okay. Do you think you can get her to come to the meeting tomorrow? I can do that. Okay, awesome. Yuri, you don't have to worry about anything, but thank you for being my friend. You're a good listener. Fidgeting with her hair, Yuri turns away to hide a smile. smile. Well, I guess for today, it's going to be a pretty quiet club meeting. I'm going to step out for a bit, is that okay? Yeah, I'm just going to read with Yuri. Hey, is this one of Natsuki's books? How come it's out here? Sayori picks up a manga that was resting on an adjacent desk. Oh, that. Natsuki probably just left it out by accident. But I thought she hasn't been coming to the club. Actually, Monica's been... Okay, Yuri. I'm sure it was just someone else who was using this classroom then, okay? Monica smiles. I'm sorry. Oh my god, Monica's a closeted weeb. then with a wave, she exits the club room. Monica's a closeted weeb. I really shouldn't have left that out. If Sayori catches on, she'll definitely tell Natsuki, and that would get really awkward. Oh my god, Monica. Now, I wonder if there's a keyboard I could borrow from. The time for the next club meeting has already arrived. Monica and Yuri are the first to arrive. I'm so worried. Do you think Sayori is going to be able to bring Natsuki? Yes. How do you know? Well, she's Sayori. You know, you're right. Time slowly passes. Monica sits and stands up to pace around and sits again. Yuri's eyes don't move from her book. Then, the door finally opens. Sayori marches in. Behind her, Natsuki shuffles inside, nervously looking around the room. We're here! Welcome back. Monica, the club president, stands up and greets them with a smile. Sayori picks a desk and takes a seat. Natsuki sits closely next to her. Looking back and forth between the club room, between the club members, Monica is struck with a nostalgic feeling. She would stand at the front of the club room just like this, struggling to picture just who may eventually be sitting before her. But imagination was never enough to predict how unique diverse each member would be. Each with her own struggles, her own reasons for seeking the vision that Monica had admittedly so vaguely advertised. Seeking trust, understanding, respect. What new lessons will the future hold for the Literature Club? Realizing she's getting ahead of herself, Monica takes a deep breath and returns to the present. Okay, everyone. The Literature Club is starting. We have an activity planned for today. Monica turns around to face the chalkboard. On it, she writes manga in big letters. Today, we're going to learn from an expert about a unique form of literature, manga. Oh, come on! Isn't that kind of forced? I know you don't actually want to do this, so just... Monica shakes her head. Natsuki. This is the hardest part. After making it this far, it would be so easy to just smile and move on. But that's not enough. Not this time. I'm sorry. It was wrong of me not to take you seriously when you were kind enough to show interest in my club. I thought about it, and I realized how biased I was against manga. It caused me to disrespect you, and I'm sorry. But I think you deserve to be able to share your passion with us. So, can I make it up to you? Well, thanks, but I know you're only doing this because Sayori told you to. Wait, that's not true. Mata planned this all by herself. I didn't even get a chance to talk to her. I was witness to I was witness to that as well. This is the Literature Club. The Literature Club is a place where everyone gets to be themselves. We all have our own interests and our differences. It's my vision to let us freely express that. And it's my goal to respect everyone for them. So, I just want to learn about the things that make you happy. I think that you deserve to share that joy as much as everyone else does. Is that okay? Natsuki looks away and hesitates. But it's really dumb, the stuff I'm into. Monica smiles. She kneels in front of Natsuki's desk, looking her straight in the eye. If you like it, then it's not dumb. Oh, except for me. Sorry, you're not dumb either. What the heck? You guys are so weird. Fine, I'll show you some of my manga. Only because you admitted that it's literature after all. Natsuki stands up. Oh yeah, I didn't say this before, but I'm actually into writing too. I'm kind of a pro. But I didn't want you to like me just for that. Wow, really? I really did have you all wrong, Natsuki. Yeah, whatever. Today's not about that anyway, right? It's about manga. So, I hope you're ready. A week has passed since Natsuki returned to the Literature Club. Since then, the club activities have been in full swing. Each member had received a day in the spotlight to share all of their favorite kinds of literature with each other. As another meeting draws to a close, Monica approaches Natsuki on the way out. Natsuki, are you in a hurry home or anything? Me? Not particularly. Why? Oh. There's just something that I wanted to show you. If you had a few minutes. Sure, what is it? It's not in here. Can you follow me to the music room? The music room? Why? Well, you'll see. You know, I was thinking back. When the club was just me and Sayori, we would talk about how we envisioned the club to turn out. We cared a lot about it being a place where people could express themselves. And she said something strange to me. She said I was trying to make the club that I needed myself more than anyone. But I think it wasn't until you joined that I fully understood that. Because you really taught me a lot about myself. Like, things that I was probably always too stubborn to admit. Oh, come on. You can't mean that. I didn't even do anything. I just brought a bunch of manga, and then I got fussy when I didn't want to have my way. It was really stupid of me to make such a big deal out of it. No, I honestly needed it. If you didn't express that you were hurt, I would never have realized that I did something wrong. Besides, your feelings are valid. They deserve to be heard and respected. It's just really hard to feel that way sometimes. You know, like, I really shouldn't care about what other people think in the first place. But when you're just criticized by everyone around you for being a certain way, it can get really hard to just brush it off. And it makes me start to feel like I'm the problem. Like I'm not doing enough to please everyone else. Am I just being too entitled if I just want people to like me without me having to hide a bunch of stuff about myself? I don't think I am. I just wish sometimes people would try to appreciate me for who I actually am. As Monica listens, she recalls vividly how Natsuki's friends were treating her, and how naturally they did so. How long has she been fighting against that, refusing to change for others? I could only wish I was as strong as you are, Natsuki. You're so honest with yourself. I'm like always trying to come off as perfect for other people. Anytime there's like a hint of contention, I just crumble. But it's thanks to you that I really started thinking about this stuff. You really inspired me to start working on it, but like I said, I didn't even do anything. You're just being yourself. That's all you needed to do. Also, there's something else. Monica takes a breath. The thing is, I might have read a little bit of your manga. What? You? What the heck? Why didn't you tell me? I'm sorry. I think I just felt like kind of embarrassed to admit it after I gave you such a hard time about it. I can't believe you, of all people, were reading manga behind my back. That's so funny. Yeah, well, I just flipped through one of them out of curiosity, but I ended up reading a whole bunch of it. But I mean, one of the characters was in a literature club. What are the chances, right? You were reading Parfait Girls? Wow, you have good taste. Just one volume? And I kind of just picked it out randomly. Well, you have good intuition then. You have to tell me your favorite parts. Well, I think it was kind of some kind of weird fate. Because the character isn't just in a literature club. She also plays piano. It's just weird. Because I always wanted to learn piano. She was like the perfect person that I always wish I was. If I just did what I wanted. Instead of always second guessing myself. Monica walks over to the piano and sits down. I always felt like I should only share the absolute best parts of myself. The parts that will impress people or make them like me more. But after you joined the club, I really realized how self-destructive that mentality is. We share things because we want to express ourselves. Sharing experiences allows us to share emotions. And I just felt like I wanted to show you this. Because if it wasn't for you, I never would have started playing. Hey, I think the credit for that one goes to the Parfait Girls, not me. No. Well, maybe it's true that the Parfait Girls put that thought into my head. But it was still you who inspired me to keep practicing every day. Every day? Because, you know, you just make me feel like if I want to do something, I should just do it. I mean, I still haven't been practicing for very long, and I'm really not good at it yet, like, at all. But I wrote a song for the club, and I worked really, really hard on it. It doesn't have any words or anything, but, well, yeah. I wonder what song that is. Is this actually a new song? That's all. That was so good.
It was?
Yeah, are you kidding? Like, already a pro. Not even close.
Does that song have a name?
You said it was about the club, so yeah. It's called My Song, Your Note. Because everyone brings something so unique to the club. It's completely different from how I first imagined it, I think. But I was like, such a selfish perfectionist. It shouldn't be about me, it should be about everyone. And it's all of you who helped shape the club into what it is. I would never change that. Well, I think that's really thoughtful and kind of flattering. I kind of feel like I don't deserve this much validation. I wasn't exactly very patient either when I first joined the club. It makes me feel like I should probably apologize too. I think I was just really fed up with a lot of things, and I got frustrated after not getting my way in the club. So yeah, I really didn't mean to take it out on you. I was probably being really immature. if you get my stubborn butt to apologize, I guess you're doing something right. It's fine. I pass it too. I think we're already even. But it's really sweet you were thinking about it. It takes a lot of maturity to reflect on that kind of thing. Well, I wonder who I got it from. Oh, never mind. Well, anyway, we're even as long as you let me keep my manga in the club room. You did admit that it's a form of literature. You totally can't take that back now. You got me. Closet's all yours. I'll tell you what. I'll bring a little something for the club tomorrow. I want to do something nice in return. What kind of little something? Oh, you'll see. But I don't think you'll be disappointed. The next club meeting ends up being a particularly tasty one. Damn, dude! We only have a few more left. We literally have 3 left. But, you know, we'll get there when we get there. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out, guys. It's been a blast.